Hey folks, welcome to the Shallow Runner channel. In this video, I'll be explaining how I built a 10-foot John boat with a 212 Predator engine that hits about 21 miles an hour. Questions I'll be answering in this video are, what engine did I put in there, how did I make it to the pump, and why this is worth building. Coming up in the near future, I have a ton of other build videos and some more updates on this boat. If this is something you're interested in, please like, subscribe, comment below. I'm hoping to get a ton more out there. As fun as this is to run, it was a little bit of a challenge to build. I'll be offering some parts on shallowrunner.com. Check out the link below. In a previous video, you saw me running with a 420 Predator. That hit about 33 miles an hour with one person and maybe 28 miles an hour with two guys. I'll be doing a whole video on the 420 build, specifically what engine parts I put in, some headaches I ran into with fuel, things like that. When I was running this bone stock, I was doing about 15 miles an hour. After running a bone stock at 15 miles an hour, I made some small changes to the pump I'll cover in a later video. That bumped it up to about 17 miles an hour. After I hit 17 miles an hour, I made some small changes to the engine. I put some larger jets in that I think I got from either OMB NR Racing. Then I put on this pretty straightforward mud motor pipe. After I upgraded the jets and the pipe, I was hitting 19 miles an hour. After running this with the larger jets and the mud motor pipe, I put in a Mikuni 22 millimeter round slide carb. I think that brought it up to about 21 miles an hour, and that's as fast as I've been able to hit.
One of the absolute best things about this boat, other than being relatively cheap to build compared to other jet boats, and being super lightweight, is that it can run super shallow. On plane, it can rip through 4 to 6 inches of water with ease. In a later video, I'll cover more about the advantage of inboard jets, but essentially you don't have a outboard on the back with a lower unit that's vulnerable to rock strikes.
The next step would be to put in a cam. I talked with NR Racing and got a pretty good idea of what cam would be best in this application. All right, so the two most asked questions, what jet pump do you have in here and how's it made it to your engine? In this case, it's simply a Waverunner 500 jet pump with a stock pitch impeller, and it's made it to the engine with direct drive.
I've rightfully seen a ton of speculation about this direct drive configuration. Both my 420 and 212 builds are set up as direct drive.
The challenge running direct drive with these engines is that you have a 1-inch keyed straight shaft that you're mating to a Yamaha Lovejoy. This Lovejoy geometry is unique to the Waverunner 500. The most straightforward way to mate these two is simply a custom adapter. That's what I have here on shallowrunner.com. This is a CNC machine from a solid block of billet aluminum, and this is made in the USA. Between your two coupler jaws is a rubber spider that works as a buffer between the two pieces of metal. It cuts down on noise, your need for lubrication, and gives you a greater tolerance for any misalignment in a metal-on-metal configuration. You can see how these mate, pretty straightforward. You slip on your spider. With the spider mated in the billet adapter, you can simply slide on your midshaft. So for this application, I took the billet coupler and just added a sleeve. You go from 3/4 inch to the 1-inch coupler. All right, so this is mated to a Waverunner 500 pump. It's a stock pump with a stock pitch impeller. I use the Solus impeller just because they tend to be a little more efficient. You might get maybe 1 to 2 miles an hour extra based off using a aftermarket impeller. It's easy to pull start. I'll show a clip here. This engine is mostly stock. I made a few changes for safety and reliability. On the reliability side, I put a billet connecting rod. It's maybe 20 thousandths over.
Also on the reliability side, I did put in some beefier push rods.
So this engine does have the governor deleted. I did that to make sure that I could see if this could, for some reason, push it up to 5,500 RPM. It can't. It hits about 3,600 RPM at 21 miles an hour. So off the water, this thing will rev to, you know, 4,000 or 5,000 RPM. That tells me when I'm running in the water and I'm only hitting 3,600 RPM, this thing is maxed out. If you're doing a governor delete, you absolutely must install a billet flywheel. If you're deleting the governor, you should definitely put in some heavier valve springs. The reason for putting heavier valve springs in is simply that when you delete the governor and you're hitting about, you know, 4,000 or 5,000 RPM, in some circumstances you can get valve float. If you're not familiar with valve float, you can Google that or check out Redbeard's Garage. There's some good information. But definitely put in some heavier duty valve springs if you decide to delete the governor. So another note about safety, if you're building one of these, you're definitely gonna wanna install a kill switch. If you're not familiar with a marine kill switch, basically you strap this to your life vest or to your wrist. It connects to a switch on the boat. And if you fall out, it will shut the motor off. So if you have questions on how to install one of these on a Predator engine, I can do another video and show you how to do it on the 212 and the 420. All right, for some specifics about this boat, it's simply a 1032. That means it's 10 feet long and it is 32 inches wide at the chines. So another big reason to build one of these is they're light. This thing weighs about 170 pounds. I have to give a shout out to three companies. Full disclosure, I'm not sponsored by any of these three companies that I'm recommending. They were just a world of help and wanted to give them a huge shout out. So the first company is Impros, the Impeller Professionals. So these guys answered a mountain of questions. Some of it was confirming some of my original research, but they gave me a few hints and pointers that made this build a lot easier and let me get to 33 miles an hour with the 420. So Impros does repairs if you need impellers, wear rings, things like that. These guys will get you exactly what you need. All right, so the other company I have to thank is NR Racing. Almost all the parts you see in this build and the 420 build were sourced from NR Racing. NR Racing answered a ton of questions patiently and helped me get the 420 to where it was and this 212 to where it is. The third company I want to thank is Redbeard's Garage. So if you've never upgraded a clone style or Predator engine, check out Redbeard's Garage. He's got a host of videos that are absolutely phenomenal. Whether you're new to the industry or you have only built one or you want to learn more. So this concludes the video. That's all I have for now. If you have other questions, put them in the comments below. Shoot me a message on shallowrunner.com and I'll try to answer anything I can.
If you're interested in building a Predator or clone engine jet boat, we have US made build adapters for Waverunner 500s on shallowrunner.com. There's a host of additional products and services in development, so please stay tuned.